At CES 2025, I'm Chris Chinnock for Insight Media. I'm in the display, Samsung display suite here in the Encore, and I'm going to take a look at their automotive displays. Samsung display is obviously focusing a lot on OLED displays. That's one of their key areas. And one of their first things that they're showing here is an OLED-based privacy solution. They call this a Flex Magic Pixel. And you can see the specifications for this demonstration device here. And if you look straight on the display, you can see that I can see both halves of the display. Actually, it's a third. And if I come onto this side, you can see the right third of the display disappears. So this is an OLED display. How do they do this? I'm told it is actually a dual pixel structure. So imagine having two sets of RGB OLED pixels independently controllable. If you have both on, you get the full display. You can have full vertical or horizontal viewing. If you turn one set off, then only the left side or the right side is visible. And so that's how they do this. It is switchable, which is a good thing. Obviously, you've got a lot more mass, a lot more pixels to fabricate, but this could be an interesting solution. Next, I want to talk about their under-camera application here. This is, again, an OLED panel now for automotive, and what they have here is a demonstration panel, and the idea is you can integrate the camera inside the display instead of having a separate camera module that would sit above the display. Now it's integrated in the display. So if I can get this thing to come on, perhaps you can see it's about a 3 millimeter window inside. I guess I can't get it on right now. On the sides here, they have these are eye tracking sensors. So an IR laser. I guess it's an LED emitter as well as a detector for eye tracking. You could potentially add those to the display later. They do not have that integrated right now, but they could do that at a later date. The way this is fabricated right now, it's actually a pick-and-place process. So they take the individual CMOS sensors and put them inside the display here. It's about a 3 millimeter window or so. In this area, Samsung Display is showing their foldable displays. They have an 18.1-inch demo in this case. And over here, you can kind of see an implementation of where these foldable and stretchable type displays can be integrated. So you've got this center console display here, which has got a nice folded profile. You've got a nice long display here on the dashboard. You've got some little displays integrated into the steering wheel. And then they've got this panoramic, quasi-panoramic display in this auto demonstrator here. These are just OLED panels with a mirror basically reflecting them up. I'm not quite sure why you would want to do this as opposed to just having the displays directly emitting toward the driver, but that's what they're demonstrating. And these are 12.3-inch devices, as you can see. They also showing over here, this is kind of a demonstration of an OLED benefit, the black levels that you can get. It's especially beneficial if your camera is looking in a dark area, like a parking garage. You do lose some of that definition in the dark area, so that is a clear advantage. They also have announced a partnership with Dolby to bring HDR content, Dolby Vision, to the automotive displays and their OLEDs. This is rather an interesting development since Samsung Electronics has very much been promoting their HDR 10 Plus concept as a competitive version to Dolby Vision. But here we have Dolby Vision partnering with Samsung Display for the automotive market to enhance that consumer electronic experience. And finally, over here, we have What they're demonstrating is this partnership with Qualcomm. Qualcomm is developing a whole chipset and software-defined OS for automotive applications. And so they're partnering, obviously, with Samsung Display here to provide an integrated solution. So this is kind of almost a turnkey solution for the whole software-defined vehicle plus display solution here. On display here is what this is a 34-inch 6K display that they've shown before. So that's pretty much the story here from Samsung Display in terms of their automotive applications. Chris Chinnock for Insight Media.